Hello children, in this session let us do exercise 6.4 from chapter number 6, squares and square roots. Okay, you have already done question number 1 and we may continue from question number 2. Okay children? Question number 2, find the number of digits in the square root of each of the following numbers without any calculation. Here we have 5 questions, and for doing this questions we should know this point. That is, when the number of digits in the given number is n, and if it is an even number, the number of digits in the square root is n by 2. And when the given number has odd number of digits, that when the number is of digits in the number is n, and if it is an odd number, the number of digits in the square root is n plus 1 divided by 2. So when the number of digits in the given number is n and it is an even number, then number of digits in the square root is n by 2. And if it has odd number of digits, then number of digits in the square root is n plus 1 by 2. Let us see in this question this point. Okay, 64, number of digits is 2. 2 is an even number. So number of digits in the square root of 64 is n by 2 is equal to n is 2, 2 by 2 is equal to 1. So children, in the square root of 64 we have 1 digit, and you know, just let us check the answer. 64, what's the square root of 64? 8. How many digits are there in 8? 1 digit. So okay, we got the same answer, 1 digit. Okay, now question number 2, 144. In 144 we have 3 digits, so number of digits in the square root of 144 is equal to, use this formula, n plus 1 by 2, because n is an odd number here. Okay, so 3 plus 1 by 2 is equal to 4 by 2. We get 2 as the answer. So number of digits in the square root is 2. And children, let us check the answer. 144. What is the square root? You have already by hearted up to 400 square roots, no? So 144 square root is 12. How many digits are there? 2. So our answer here we got as 2 digits, right? Question number 3, 4489. How many digits are here? 4 digits. So 4 is an even number. So number of digits in the square root is equal to n by 2 is equal to n is 4, 4 by 2 is equal to 2. Okay children, and you know the square root of 4489 is 67, and 67 has 2 digits only, right? Now next question is 27,225. In this number we have 5 digits. It is an odd number, means the number of digits is 5 and 5 is an odd number. So odd number of digits coming there, n plus 1 by 2. And n plus 1, here n is 5, 5 plus 1, 6, 6 by 2 is equal to 3. And children, in the square root of 27,225 we have 3 digits. Okay. Now, next number is 390,625. And children, here the number of digits is 6, and 6 is an even number. So if the number is even, we have to use this formula, n by 2. So n is 6, 6 by 2 is equal to 3. So in the square root we have 3 digits. And children, this number square root is 625. So in 625 we have 3 digits only. Okay children? Question number 3, find the square root of the following decimal numbers. Question number 1 is 2.56. Here children, we have to first group the numbers. We have to put the bars. Your integer part or integral part forms one group. We have only one digit here, so we have to put the bar upside. And in decimal part, we have only 2 digits. So these 2 digits, 5 and 6, form another group, and second bar will come above 5 and 6. Okay, now after putting bars we have to start division. And first of all, think, what is the square root of first group, that is 2? Square root of 2 is between the squares 1 and 4. The number 2 is between the squares 1 and 4, and 1 is the smaller number there. So what is the square root of 1? It is 1. So we are putting here 1. Now the same number you write in the quotient side. 1 into 1, multiply. We get 1. 1 into 1, 1 right here. And do subtraction. 2 minus 1, 1. Now next group, copy down. So the number becomes 156. And we already wrote here 1. It's doubled. 1 into 2, 2 right here on the left side. Okay. Now here it is a decimal number. We have the point here. So we put the point in the quotient side. Now right side of 2, we have to write 1 digit. The same digit will come in the quotient side also. Okay. So what number can we write here on the right side of 2? For this, see this dividend. Here units place we have 6. So which number into number gives you 6? Number into number we have to get 6. So which numbers are possible? 4 into 4 you get 16. So 6 we have in the units place. Similarly 6 into 6 36. So two possibilities are there. When we write here 4 or 6, there is chance of getting 6 here. So we have to try with these numbers. When you multiply by 24 into 4, we have to write here 4, right? So 24 here 4 writing and here 4 writing there. Multiplication we have to do. 24 into 4, we are not getting 156. And when you write here 6 and upside also 6 and multiply 26 into 6, we get 156. And so we are, our correct number is 6 here, and upside also we write the same number 6. Now we have to do subtraction. 156 minus 156 is equal to 0. So the division is ending here. Okay. So the square root of 2.56 is 1.6. Okay, children. Now question number 2. 7.29. First of all, we have to group the numbers. We have to put the bars. So integer part here, we have only one digit, so it will form one group. And decimal part, we have only two digits, so it forms the other group. Okay, so we are starting the division here. First thing, what is the square root of 7? 7 is not a perfect square, but it lies between the squares 4 and 9. 7 lies between the squares 4 and 9. 4 is smaller. And what is the square root of 4? It is 2. So we write here 2. Upside also we write 2. Now multiply. 2 2's are 4. 7 minus 4, it is 3. Now next group, copy down. 29 we are writing here. So the new number is 329. We have 2 in the quotient side. It's double, we write on the left side of 329. So 2 into 2, 4. Now we have to write one more digit on the right side of 4. What it will be? For this, you think how you are getting 9. Which number into number gives you 9? You have two options. 3 into 3, 9. 7 into 7 also 49. Then also we have 9 in units place. So two possibilities are there. 43 into 3 and 7 into 7. When you do 43 multiplied by 3, you are not getting 329. But when you do 47 into 7, you get 329. So our correct number is 7. We write on the right side of 4 as well as in the quotient side. Okay. And we write here 329. And now to subtraction 2 and we get 0. Okay. So here the division stops. So the square root of 7.29 is 2.7. Okay, children. Now question number 3. 51.84. First we have to group the numbers. We have to make the bars. So integer part we have only 51. So 51 forms one group. And decimal part we have only two digits. 8, 4. And these two digits together form another group. Okay. So now we may do division. First we have to think what is the square root of 51. Children, 51 is not a perfect square. But 51 lies between the squares 49 and 64. 51 number. The number 51 lies between the squares 49 and 84. And from this 49 and 84, 64, what is smaller? 49 is smaller. So, what is the square root of 49? 7. So, we are writing 7 on the left side of 51. Okay. And 7 you write in the quotient side also. Now, 7 sevens are 49. We write here and we have to do subtraction. 51 minus 49, it is equal to 2. Now, what we have to do? Next group, copy down. 84. So, the number becomes 284. Now, we have to write something on the left side of 284. What it is? Here, in the quotient side, we have 7. So, it's double. 7 into 2, 14. So, we have to first write 14. How do we get 14? 7 into 2. Okay, this 2 not. Always, we have to multiply first digit into 2. 7 2s are 14. Now, one digit we have to write on the right side of 14. And the same digit will come in the quotient side also. Okay, so here, first thing children, here we have 4. And what number into number gives you 4? Or what can be the square root of 4? It is 2. So, 2 into 2, 4. Similarly, we can have 8 into 8. There, 64. We have 4 in the units place. So, children, we have to try with 142 into 2. And when we try 142 into 2, we get 284. Here also, opposite also, we have 284. So, that is the correct answer. So, we are writing here 2. And in the quotient side also, we write 2. Okay. So, subtraction time, we get 0. So, here division stops. So, the square root of 51.84 is 7.2. Okay, children. Now, question number 4. 42.25. Here, we have to put the bars. And 4 and 2 form one group. So, we are putting one bar here. And decimal part, we have only two digits. So, these two digits form another group. Now let us start the division. Think, what is the square root of 42? 42 is not a perfect square, but this number 42 lies between the perfect squares 36 and 49. The number 42 lies between the squares 36 and 49. And 36 is smaller. What is the square root of 36? 6. So we are writing 6 here. The same digit we write in the quotient side also. Okay. Now we multiply 6. 6 are 36. 42 minus 36. We get here 6. And now next group you copy down. It is 25 and we copy down 25 and the number becomes 625. Now children, we have to write something on the left side. And you know, we have to first write the double of 6. 6 into 2, 12. We write 6 into 2, 12. Okay. Now, what comes on the left right side of 12? For this, you see, which number into number gives you 5 here? So, you know, when in the square, when we have 5, in the square root, we have 5 in the units place. So, try with 5. 125 into 5, we have to multiply and calculate. And multiplying time, we get 625. So, here, what number we have to write? 5. In the quotient side also, you write 5. So, 625 we are writing here and subtracting, then we get 0. Okay, children. So, here the division stops and we get 6.5 as the square root. Okay. So, last step we write as square root of 42.25 is equal to 6.5. Okay, children. I think you might have understood how to do these questions. And question number 5, I give us homework. Okay, children. This much we do today and remaining next day we may see. Okay, children.